students, welcome back to physics online class. In last session I gave some assignment questions related to Coulomb's law, so hope you solve those kind of questions. So today let me solve some shortcut formulas related to Coulomb's law, so you may solve those questions more easier manner if you use these kind of formulas. So let me understand what are the shortcut formulas related to Coulomb's law. So for example, they will give two kind of charges. So for example, when the same charges are separated by same distance in different media, for example, they may ask the question like so. So they will give two charges. These two charges are separated by a same distance. For example, I will take that charge Q1 here and charge Q2 here, and these two charge initially if I place in an air medium, and now I will place between these two charge particle, for example, oil medium is there. So separation is same. So Q1 and Q2, first I will place it in an air medium, then I will place it in an oil medium. Separation between these two charge will be same. So here separation is same. So here which thing is different here? Dielectric constant value is different. So here K1 is not equal to K2. Then what is the formula here? So from the Coulomb's law, initially if you place the charge particle in a air medium, air or vacuum, so F is equal to 1 by K1, 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q1 into Q2 by R square here. Or shall I rearrange this equation in this fashion? So F1 K1 is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q1 into Q2 by R square here. And if the same charge particle separated by a same distance, and now these two, between these two charge particle, ion medium is there. So for different dielectric value, so 1 by K2, so F is equal to 1 by K2, same, 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q1 into Q2 by R square. Here I mentioned that charge is same and separation is also same. So then shall I rearrange this equation here? F2 into K2 is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q1 into Q2 by R square. So if I compare these two equations, so after comparing these two equations, right hand side 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q1 into Q2 by R square is there. If I compare these two equations, shall I write this equation here? F1 K1 is equal to F2 into K2. So this equation is applicable when the same charges are separated by a same distance in different media. So here charge is same and separation is same, but that medium is different one. So then what is the formula? F1 K1, it is equal to F2 into K2. For example, so in the question they may ask like so. For example, between the two charge particle, if it is placed in an air medium, its force value is 5 Newton. So for that air medium, dielectric constant is 1 for air or vacuum. The same two charge particle is placed in an oil medium for the same separation. So oil having the dielectric constant 2 here, then what is the change in force? So look at here. Here two charge particles are there. One is Q1, another one is Q2. Between these two charge particles, so there exists a certain kind of separation. Initially, between this charge particle, air medium is there. If air medium is there, means its force value is 5 Newton. So now the same charge particle, I placed it in a oil medium. So that oil having the dielectric constant value 2 here. Then force value will get changes. So force is depends upon the medium between the charge particle, I said. Then what about the new force here? F1 K1 is equal to F2 into K2. Initial force is 5 Newton. For air or vacuum, dielectric constant value is 1. So F2 is yet to be determined here. K2 value is 2. So then F2 value is 5 by 2. So F2 value is 2.5 Newton. So look at here. After placing that dielectric medium value, force value will get decreases here. So remember this formula: when the same charges are separated by a same distance in different media. So what's the formula here? F1 K1 is equal to F2 into K2 here. So next one. So next formula, the same charges are separated by different distance here. So here distance is different. So R1 is not equal to R2 for different distance and same media. So for example, I will take the charge particle Q1 and Q2. Those two charge particle, first I will place it in a same media dimension. For example, here that charge particle Q1 and here that charge particle Q2 here. So initially, so separation between these charge particle is R1. So these charge particle is placed in a air medium. So air medium having the dielectric constant 1, for example, or whatever the medium. Here charge is same and dielectric constant is same. So now I would like to increase the separation here. So if I increase the separation, means I'm changing the distance between the charge particle, then of course force value will get changes here. Then how to find out the new force here? So same thing, 1 by F1 is equal to, so here they mention same charges and same media. So same charges and same media means 1 by F1 is equal to 1 by K, 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q1 into Q2 by R1 square. I will rearrange this equation as F1 R1 square. It is equal to 1 by K, 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught, or Q1 into Q2 by 4 pi epsilon naught. So in second case, dielectric medium will be same. So just I am changing the distance for a different distance, Q1 into Q2 divided by R2 square here. I will rearrange. Shall I rearrange this equation here? So F2 R2 square is equal to 1 by K Q1 into Q2 by 4 pi epsilon naught. Again, I will compare these two equations. If I compare these two equations, what will be the final equation? I get it here. F1 R1 square is equal to F2 R2 square. What is the formula? If the same charges are separated by different distance in a same medium, here charge is same and medium is same, here distance is different. For a different distance, what is the change in force here? F1 R1 square, it is equal to F2 into R2 square. So look at here, two charges are separated by different distance in a same media. Thus that formula is F1 R1 square is equal to F2 into R2 square. So related to these formula, so in yesterday assignment I given one question. So let me read that question. Okay, 11th question. The force between two charges 0.06 meter apart is 5 Newton. So force between the two charge is 5 Newton and its separation is, so its separation is 0.06 meter or 6 into 10 to the power of minus 2 meter. If the charges are moved towards each other by 0.1 meter. So look at here. So this is charge Q1 and this one is charge Q2. Initial separation is 0.06 meter. Now these two charges are moved 0.01 meter towards dimension. So if you moved 0.01 meter towards, means then what is the new separation here? Initial separation is 0.06. You are decreasing the distance 0.01. Then what's the distance between these two here? 0.05 meter. So look at here, initial separation they mention as a 0.06 meter and these two charge move towards each other by 0.01. So these two charges are moved each other by 0.01 meter, means what's the second distance here? So remaining distance is 0.05 meter or 5 into 10 to the power of minus 2 meter. Then what about the new force? So by using these formulas, so easily I can calculate that force F2 value here. F1 is 5 Newton. Initial distance is 6. 6 square means 36 into 10 to the power of minus 4. F2 value is to be determined. R2 value is 5 square. So 25 into 10 to the power of minus 4 here. 5 ones are 5, 5 are 36 divided by 5. So F2 value is how much? 36 divided by 5. So 60 means 6.12. So F2 value is 6.12 Newton here. So look at here, as the distance you are decreasing, force value is increases here. So from that Coulomb's law, so force is inversely proportional to square of the distance between them. If the distance is 6 meter, so force value is 5 Newton. If that distance is decreases to 5 meter, so its force value will becomes as a 6.12 Newton. So hope you understand here. So next question means next cases. If the different charges are separated by same distance in a same medium. So look at here. So in the first case, I taken that dielectric medium is different. In the second case, I taken that distance is different. In the third case, I will take that charge is different. So different charges I will take here. And these two different charges are placed in a different media. So look at the third application here. If different charges are placed by a same distance and same medium here, so two different charges I will take and these two charges I will place it in a same medium and same separation, then what about the change in force I will calculate here? So in order to calculate the change in force, so look at here, I will take that two different charges here. So initial charge I will take it as a Q1 and Q2, and these two charges are separated by a distance r here. For example, in the first case, I will take the charge Q1 here, and at a certain distance from the Q1, another charge Q2 I will take it here. Between these two charge particle, air medium is there, and separation is r I will consider here. Separation is same, as well as dielectric medium is also same. Now in the second case, I will take the different charge here, Q1 dash, and another charge is Q2 dash. Separation between them is same R, and dielectric medium is same air. I will take it here. Then what about the new force here? So look at here. So F1 is equal to 1 by K, 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q1 into Q2 by R square. So let me rearrange here. So how shall you rearrange, or I will divide these equations. So for example, take this one as a equation 1. In the second case, 1 by k, 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught here, charge value is different here, q1 dash into q2 dash, and remaining thing will be same. So now I will divide these two equations. So if I divide these two equations, f2 by f1 here, 1 by k 4 pi epsilon naught, this will get cancelled out, this will get cancelled out, and this is getting cancelled out. So F2 is equal to, sorry, F2 by F1 is equal to Q1 dash into Q2 dash divided by Q1 into Q2. So look at here, when the different charges are separated by a same medium and same separation here. Here charge is different, separation is same, and medium is same. Then what about the change in force here? F2 by F1 is equal to Q1 dash into Q2 dash divided by Q1 into Q2. If charge is different, so in the first case, medium is different. In the second case, so distance is different. In the third case, charge is different. For different charges, what is the formula? F2 by F1 is equal to Q1 dash into Q2 dash divided by Q1 into Q2. So in last class I given some assignment. So in that assignment, by using this formula, easily I will get some values here. So I will read out the question here. For example, look at the question number 8 here. So in 8th question, so somehow it's interesting question. Let me solve this question. So look at here. Two point charges A and B having plus Q and minus Q respectively. For example, here two bodies are there. One is A, another body is B. On the body A, plus Q amount of charge is there. On the body, minus Q amount of charge is there. Are placed at a certain distance apart and force between them is F. So in this situation, separation is R and force between these two is F. So let me read the question. If 25% of charge A is transferred to charge B here. So from that A, how much charge I am transferring here? 25% of the charge is transferring from that A to B here. So 25% of the charge is transferring from A to B is then what about the change in force? Here charge is transferring means here that which thing is same here? So distance is same dimension. So distance is same and medium is same. Here charge is transferring means charge value will get changed here. So initially if 25% of the charge is transferring from A to B, A is having plus Q charge. So 25% means 25/100 × Q. So it means that how much charge is transferring from that A to B here? Q by 4 amount of charge is transferring from that A to B here. So out of 100%, if 25% of the charge is moving from A to B, means what about the new charge in A? So new charge in A is, so that is Q dash of A. So Q dash of A is equal to initial charge is plus Q. How much charge is leaving from A here? Q by 4 amount of charge is leaving here. Why? Because 25% of the charge is transferring. It means that Q by 4 amount of charge is leaving from that A to B here. So 4Q minus of Q. So that is 3Q by 4 here. So what is the new charge on the body A here? 3Q by 4 here. Then what about the new charge on the body B here? So Q dash of B. So on the body B, what is the initial charge? Minus Q amount of charge is there. How much charge is adding here? So 25% of the charge is moving from A to B, means on the body B, how much charge is adding here? Q by 4 amount of charge is adding to the body B here. So plus Q by 4 here. So minus 4Q plus of Q, minus 3Q by 4 here. What is the new charge on the body B here? Minus 3Q by 4. So from the formula, what's the formula I said here? So F2 by F1 is equal to Q1 dash into Q2 dash divided by Q1 into Q2. F2 by F1 is equal to, just I will take magnitude of the force. Q dash of A, Q dash of B divided by Q of A into Q of B. So Q dash of A is how much? So 3Q by 4. Q of B is also, just I will take magnitude of the charge. So I won't consider that positive and a negative sign here. Q of A is Q and this is also Q. So F2 by F1, it is equal to, so 9Q square by 16 divided by Q square here. So F2 is equal to F1 by 16 here. So F2 is equal to 9 F1 by 16 here. So what is the new force here? F2 is equal to 9 F1 by 16 here. So here they mention 25% of the charge is transferring from A to B, means from that A, how much charge is transferring here? Out of 100%, 25% of the charge is moving from A to B, means Q by 4 amount of charge is leaving from A to B. So that is initial charge is plus Q, Q by 4 amount of charge is leaving. So then what is the new charge on the A? So 3Q by 4 here. So in the next case, in the body B, minus Q amount of charge is there. So how much charge is adding from that A to B here? Q by 4 amount of charge is adding. So that is plus Q by 4. I got minus 3Q by 4. I got a new charge on the body A as well as on the body B. By making simplification, I got that F2 is equal to 9 by 16 of F1. So hope you understand here. So related to this one, same. Next question. So hope you solve the next question. Ninth question. Two charges repel each other with the force of 100 Newton. Here they mentioned two charges. And these two charges are repel with a force of 100 Newton. So what is that initial force they mention here? initial force is 100 newton. So F1 is 100 newton. 100 newton. If one of the charge is increased by 10%, another charge is reduced by 10%, then the new force of repulsion at the same distance would be. So I need to calculate that F2 value here. So they mention Q dash of A. So one charge is increased by 10%. So increased by 10% means 110 by 100 of Q here. So what is the new charge here? 11 by 10 Q. Another one is decreased by 10%. So decreased by 10% means, shall I take it as a 90 by 100 here? 90 by 100 here. So 9 by 10 Q. So I got new charge on the body A as well as body B. So they mention that, so separation is the same and placed it in the same medium. So again I will use the same formula here, F2 by F1. So F2 by F1 means Q dash of A into Q dash of B divided by Q of A into Q of B here. So Q dash A, if A is how much? 11 by 10 Q, and Q dash of B is 9 by 10 Q here, and this is Q and this is also Q, so Q square. So F2 by F1 it is equal to, hope you understand here. So F2 by F1 here, 11 into 9 divided by 10 into 10 into Q square divided by Q square, it will get cancelled out here. F2 by F1 is equal to 99 by 100 here. New force value is F2 is equal to 99 by 100 into F1 here. What is the value of F1? So they mention as a 100 newton. So F2 is equal to 99 by 100 into F1 is 100. So what is the new force here? New force is 99 newton here. What is the new force here? New force is 99 newton here. So hope you understand here. So next, fourth one. If the force between two charge is different, sorry, I will read once again. If force between two charges in a different medium is same for different separation. So look at here. If a force between two charges, so I will consider two charges, between the two charges, force between two charges in a different medium is the same for a different separation. So here, in order to get the same force value, so F1 is equal to F2. So if the force between two charges in a different medium, so I will consider two charge particle, those two charge particle I will place it in a different medium. For example, first I will place the charge particle in an air medium, then I will place the charge particle in an oil medium. Even though by changing the medium I want to get the same force, how it is possible to get the same force by changing the medium? So by changing the different medium I want to get the same force means I should vary the distance here. So if I vary the distance between the charge particle in air medium as well as in the material medium, I want to get the same force here. So look at here, I will make you understand here. So in that fourth case, they mentioned that in order to get the same force in case of different media, I should vary the distance here. So for example, here two charge particles are present, here charge Q1, another charge particle is Q2 here. Distance between them is R1 here and dielectric constant is A. Now I will place the same charge particle here, charge particle is same, and these two charge particle are placed in a oil medium. So I will change the distance as a R2 here. So in the first case I got that force between the charge particle as a 5 newton. In the second case also I want that same 5 newtons of force. So look at here, I want to get the same force between the charge particle in air medium as well as in a oil medium. So in order to get the same force in air medium as well as in the oil medium means I should vary the distance here. It means that for which distance in case of a material medium I want to get the same force as in the air medium. So look at here, in order to get the same 5 newtons force, what should be the distance I need to maintain in case of a medium here? For a different distance I want to get the same force here. So by changing the distance here, here distance is for example, here distance is large one. So now I am decreasing the distance here. If I decrease the distance, force value will get increased here. So here that whatever the dielectric medium is there, dielectric medium will reduce the force here. If I decrease the distance, means force value will get increased here. So whatever the force is lost by this dielectric medium, so I want to gain that force here. So in order to regain that force, I should decrease the distance here. For which distance I want to get the same force in air as well as in a material medium. So hope you understand here. So here they mention that two charges, if two charges, first I will place it in a air medium, then the same two charges I will place it in a oil medium. I want to get the same force here. So in order to get the same force, I should decrease the distance here. So for what distance I will get the same force, I need to calculate here. So initially force value will be same. F is equal to 1 by K1, 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught, same charges for different distance here. So here that 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught. So for a distance here, second case, F is equal to 1 by K2, 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q1 into Q2 by R2 square here. So I will rearrange this equation here. So in order to get the same force, I will equate these two equation. If I equate these two equation, these terms will get cancelled out here. So if these term will get cancelled out, means what's the equation remains here? So force value will be same, I mentioned. So force value will be same means here that, for example, K1 R1 square, it is equal to what? Are you are going to be cancel out or you are going to be rearrange here? So 1 by, sorry, K1 R1 square is equal to Q1 into Q2 by 4 pi epsilon naught into F. So here also same. You want to make cancel out or you will rearrange this equation? K2 into R2 square. So I am rearranging here. No need to cancel out here. So K2 into R2 square is equal to Q1 into Q2 4 pi epsilon naught into F here. So if I am comparing these two equations, what's the final equation I will get it here? K1 R1 square is equal to K2 into R2 square. What is the formula here? K1 R1 square is equal to K2 into R2 square. So for my consideration, K1 is air or vacuum. For air or vacuum, its value is 1 here. So K2 value, for example, I need to calculate for which distance I want to get the same force here. So R2 value I need to calculate here. So R1 square by K2 is equal to R2 square. Or finally R2 is equal to R1 divided by square root of K. So in order to get the same force in a medium, so distance between the charge particle, so the distance between the charge particle is equal to initial distance divided by square root of the dielectric constant. So look at here, if the force between the two charges in a different medium is same for different separation, so force value will be same here. In order to get the same force value, I need to vary the distance here. So for which distance I want to get the same force between the charge particle in air medium as well as in any other dielectric medium? In order to get the same force, what should be the distance between the charge particle in the material medium? Distance between the charge particle is equal to original distance in case of air medium divided by square root of K times of the dielectric constant. So hope you understand here. So related to this one also, we'll solve some numericals. So I think in last assignment, so the question is related to this formula only. So look at 12th last question. Two charges separated by 5 cm experiencing a repulsive force is F. So two charges separated by 5 cm experiencing a repulsive force is F. The distance in centimeter between them is an oil of dielectric constant K. That K value is two dimension to have the same force is. So let me read the question once again. Two point charges separated by 5 centimeters. So initially two charges are there. Between those two charges separation is 5 centimeters. It experiencing a repulsive force F. The distance between them in an oil so to have the same force. So the same charge particle I will place it in an oil medium. That oil medium having the dielectric constant 2 here. So in order to get the same repulsive force, what should be the distance I need to maintain in an oil medium here? So R2 is equal to R1 by square root of K here. So R2 is equal to R1 value is 5 divided by root 2 here. So R2 is equal to 5 divided by 1.41 or 50 by 14.1 here. So 15 by 14.1. So 3 point. So around about 3.5 centimeter here. So what about that new distance here? So in order to get the same repulsive force, so look at here. So two charge particles are there. Initially between those two charge particles, initial separation is 5 centimeter in air or vacuum. Now the same charge particle, I will place it in a oil of dielectric constant K2. I want to get the same force means, so distance should be get decreases here. For which distance I will get the same force here? In air medium, separation is 5 centimeter and in the oil medium, separation is 3.5 centimeter. For this separation, I will get the same force. So, hope you understand. In next class, we will discuss about a force between multiple charges. So, that is nothing but a superposition principle. So, related to superposition principle also, they will ask the varieties of numericals in theory as well as in a competitive examination. In next class, we will look at that principle of superposition of the charges or force between the multiple charges.